Hey, hey, folks, and welcome to the latest installment of Dave's Impressions. This time around, Sunset Overdrive, a fast and vibrant third-person shooter with a carefree attitude. These impressions were taken from playing the game for around 1 hour and 30 minutes. Enjoy! Sunset Overdrive is brash. I love how the game dropped me right in the thick of it. Whatever the inciting incident, it had already happened, and all I needed to do was survive and learn how to play the game. It won me over with its color, slick movement, and punk rock soundtrack. The key to Sunset Overdrive is to always be on the move. In other games, I would count this as a negative, but at least here, the home base is an opportunity for the player to catch their breath, as well as accessorize. Expression through how we look is always important in games like this. The social commentary is on the nose. The zombies in this game are people who have overdosed on an experimental energy drink from a malevolent megacorporation. Their PR has stopped the National Guard from getting involved while their security tries to contain the menace and stop any survivors from speaking about the incident to the outside world. Those I found myself teaming up with were all former employees of the Corp and had their own grievances against it. The game is self-aware too.
If this were a video game, I could just go to a menu or something.
Pay attention, player!
Why am I hearing disembodied voices?
They're just winking at the camera in terms of disembodied voices teaching game systems and the silliness of the general premise itself. Sometimes the meta humor made me laugh, other times it caused me to roll my eyes. Your mileage may vary. When out in the open world, I was safe as long as I was high above the streets and always moving. There's a generous auto-aim when shooting monsters. The weapons are frenetic and inventive, and ammo will shower out from the corpses of the fallen. This meant I needed to get close to the action in order to keep firing, but in more an exhilarating you-can't-catch-me way rather than a risk-versus-reward way. Early on while learning the game, I became frustrated by the bouncing and grinding mechanics. I got trapped on world geometry and panicky. Panicking in any game is a bad idea. My mistake was in being too precise. Once I trusted the game's ability to correct the way I played, the panicking ceased. The game became effortless and more fun in the process. Challenge wasn't removed because new mutants were introduced, requiring more involvement from me than just grinding and firing. I sometimes had to change direction on the fly. So, should you play Sunset Overdrive? Well, it's what I would call a solid, fun video game. It feels like if you had a rainy afternoon where you wanted something to just kick back and have a few laughs with, this will do it for you. I find it an easy recommendation to make, but there's nothing about the game which stands out as exceptional either. It feels like it could get tiresome the more I played, at least if I tried to collect the ingredients for the amp power-ups or to engage in the multiplayer component, which rewards single player, but I wasn't able to try it out. For the short time I spent with Sunset Overdrive, however, I had a lot of fun. As always, I would love to hear what you think about Sunset Overdrive down in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, why not buy me a coffee? There's a link in the description. If you'd like to help me out in other ways, please give the video a like, share it on your favorite social media sites, or subscribe if you haven't already. Until next time, I hope you're all having a wonderful day.